for cleaning and my favorite tips. First thing, I want to talk about wood. I use this Pledge Expert Care Orange Enhancing Polish to shine and protect my wood, but I also have an orange oil that I use to clean the wood from Pledge. You can also make your own. I think you can find on the internet that people make it with lemon or orange oil. So that really shines and protects your wood. The next surface that I want to talk about is glass. Glass cleaner. This glass cleaner is amazing. I use it for mirrors and windows, but I also use it for chrome and stainless steel, and it really shines everything. I use it on my fridge, my stainless steel dishwasher, and garbage can. For toilets, I have two boys, so their toilet gets kind of gross, so I spray this bathroom cleaner from Scrubbing Bubbles on the toilet, and I keep it there for about 5 minutes. And then I wipe it down. I also use a Q-tip for the hard to reach areas that the boys also seem to go to the bathroom on, where the toilet clips on the toilet seat. I use a Q-tip to get that area all clean. Another cleaner I want to talk about is Cascade. I use that for my jetted tub. Jetted tubs get really gunky, and sometimes I just kind of wish we didn't have one. We're eventually going to get rid of it. We're eventually going to redo our bathroom. But right now we can't afford that. So I try to run the Cascade through maybe twice a month. Or I take a cloth after every bath and I just kind of run it through the jets, because they can get kind of gross. Of course, I have this roller, lint roller that goes on floors, and it picks up all my hair. I have a lot of hair, so I get hair on the bathroom floor. So I do that every day. And then for every day or every week cleaning, we use a Shark steam mop, mainly for our kitchen floors. It's not very good for wood. And then you can also use a Swiffer with an old cloth, spray on some Lysol. And I also got these wet Swiffer mop cloths as well, but I probably won't repurchase them because I don't really like the smell, and it kind of leaves everything sticky. So you can definitely just use an old t-shirt or a rag with your Swiffer. You don't have to keep buying the cloths to go with them. Soaking something in vinegar. Vinegar works for everything. Some people don't like the smell, but it works for stainless steel, glass, and I use it on my shower heads. I soak a cloth, leave it there overnight, and it takes off the water spots. I also do it for the faucets and for the drain stoppers. Also for the drain stoppers, you can put them in the dishwasher. You can put almost anything in the dishwasher. Put the boys' bath toys, toothbrush holders, plastic bins in the dishwasher. And I also found that you can put a shower curtain in the washing machine, which I haven't done yet. I'm a little worried. But instead of just getting a new one, you can do that too. So those are some lazy, easy ideas that you could do to get everything clean. Also, I want to share a home fragrance mix. Instead of buying sprays for the bathroom or for the toilet, I get glass bottles like this and I fill them up with hydrogen peroxide or witch hazel, water, and 20 to 30 drops of your favorite essential oils. I like lavender, I like lemon, orange, and I love rose. And you can make your own sprays for the bathroom, and maybe a pillow spray with lavender, and it works very well. Now I'm going to talk about organizational items that I love for bathroom and laundry. I really like using drawer organizers because it just makes everything look better. I'm not crazy about our bathroom. I think it's kind of old fashioned. I see other YouTubers' bathrooms are gorgeous, but it makes me feel better to have everything organized and clear and clutter free. So I use these plastic, clear drawer organizers, and I put a paper down. This looks like white marble paper, and it just makes everything look classier. I've also found that instead of having the under your cabinets, which is bottles everywhere, I use these two clear Lazy Susans. It makes everything look nicer and more organized. And I put it on a paper, one of my drawer organizer papers, the drawer liners. And this is a marble one, and it just makes everything look nicer. Sometimes your wood looks kind of dingy from all your products over the years, so it's nice to have drawer paper in there to protect it. Also, I found instead of having just different shampoo bottles, body wash bottles in your shower, it looks nice if you get some uniform bottles. My husband didn't believe me at first, and then now he sees it and he thinks it looks a lot better. I got these black and white bottles for face wash, body wash, shampoo, and conditioner, and that's all we have in the shower, and it looks very, very nice, almost like a hotel. And then instead of having a big bag of Epsom salts out by my bath, I put it in this cute little container. It's the gray and white marble container. We're going to be doing our bathroom over again, mainly making it gray and white. So I got a lot of gray and white bottles to match. And then I've also found soap dispensers just make things look better. I know it's kind of a pain. You have to put the soap in every couple weeks, but I think it just kind of classes up the area. We have them in our bathrooms and then in our kitchen, and I think it just looks nicer. For my laundry, I found these two pop-up laundry hampers. I love them. I hang them up in my closet, one in my closet, and I gave one to my son because he was throwing everything on the floor. And then you unclip it and you take it down and it just stands up. And then when you're done with your laundry, you fold it in and you take it down. And I love it. Instead of having a bag where you have to keep it open, this automatically stays open. You just throw your clothes in. It's easy for my son. He just throws his clothes in instead of trying to open the bag and then putting the clothes on the floor. He uses his pop-up laundry hampers. And I found those on Amazon. It came in a set of two. I also found that these cute little hedgehog dryer balls, I put a couple, instead of using static sheets, I use dryer balls. These are plastic, and then I put essential oils on it, and I put it in with my blankets, sheets, towels, my clothes, because I like the smell of lavender and rose, but I don't do it for anyone else's clothes. And it really works well. It helps with static, and it makes your clothes smell nice. I found this in my classroom. I was finding that all of my headphones were tangled up. The kids would ask for them and I couldn't get them untangled. So I found that a shoe organizer with labels, give your kids numbers, put the labels on, and then put the headphones in there, and it works beautifully. And it has saved my classroom and all my headphones. And the last thing, I found these S hooks from another YouTuber, and I love them. I want to get more. All you have to do is fold your jeans or pants with the belt loop, hang them up, and it looks really, really nice. And you can see each pair of pants. My husband wants to get some more because he saw that I had some, and they really make your closet look nicer. So those are all my tips and hacks for cleaning and organizing. I really hope you enjoy this video. Comment down below if there are any things that you like to use for cleaning and organizing, and I will see you in the next video.